In this video, we will learn how to fetch real-time data for the given securities from the interactive broker's server. Fetching real-time data. The IBridgePy package contains two methods, namely Data.current and showRealTimePrice method to fetch real-time data. Let us see how to use each of these methods. Data.current method. The Data.current method returns the real-time data for the given securities for the specified fields. The slide shows the syntax of the Data.current method. The security argument in the Data.current method signifies the security object, created by either using the symbol, symbols or the superSymbols functions. The fields argument can take values like the ask price, ask size, bid size, last traded price, etc. Let us take some examples and see how the method is used. Let us see how to pull real-time data for a single security with a single field passed to it. First, we create a security object using the Apple stock. This security object is used as the argument to the data.current method. We specify the field for which we want to pull the data as the second argument to the data.current method. The method will return a scalar value of the selected field, which can be seen in the Python console. Let us now see how to pull data for a single security with a list of fields. In this case, we specify a list of fields instead of a single field as the second argument to the data.current method. A pandas series is returned whose indices are the fields, and whose values are scalar values for this asset for each field. In the third example, let us pass a list of securities and a list of fields. First, we create a security object which contains a list of securities. This security object is passed to the data.current method along with the list of fields for which we want to pull the data. In this case, a pandas data frame is returned, which is indexed by securities. The columns represent the requested fields, filled with the scalar values for each security for each field. To pull real-time data for a futures contract, we use the superSymbol function and specify the relevant fields of the futures contract as arguments to the function. This security object is passed to the data.current method to fetch the real-time data. We can use the same superSymbol function to fetch data for an options contract as illustrated in this example. Another way to fetch real-time data is using the showRealTimePriceData method. showRealTimePrice method. The showRealTimePrice method is used to request real-time quotes of the specified security from Interactive Broker's server. The real-time prices are received automatically until the request is cancelled. In case the user has not subscribed to the real-time quotes of the requested security, an error message is thrown. The slide shows the syntax of the showRealTimePrice method. The method takes a security object which is created using the symbol function. The version argument takes valid values like bid price, ask price and the last price. Let us see how this is done in Python. As can be seen, the method pulls real-time values for the specified field. That is all for this video lecture. In this video, we saw how to fetch real-time data from Interactive Broker's server. In the next video, we will learn how to fetch historical data using IBridgePy.